Hello friends, myself Pratik Deshpande, student at NIPA Hyderabad. Welcome to another vlog. In this vlog, we are gonna discussing about the GATB exam, its pattern, and a brief information about the GATB exam. And specially to explain the information about the GATB, with me today, my friend Vibhusha Chaudhary is there. Currently, she is pursuing her master's in bioprocess technology from one of the prestigious institute of India, that's the ICT Mumbai. So to get in all the idea, all the information, watch the video till the end.
Okay. Hello and welcome, Vibhusha, and thanks for joining me. So before we get to our discussion, I would request you to please introduce yourself to our viewers.
Hello, everyone. Myself, Vibhusha Chaudhary. I've completed my BPharm. I'm currently pursuing my M.Tech at ICT Mumbai. In bioprocess technology. So I'm here to introduce you about what is GATB exam, what is its syllabus, how many questions, what are two parts, and how the procedure for procedure after GATB is done. So here I am. So what is GATB? So GATB is a graduate aptitude test for biotechnology, which is conducted by RCB, which is a conducting body. So about the exam. So exam consists of total 120 questions and the time is 180 minutes. And they consist of two parts, part A and part B. So the part A has total 60 questions and part B has total 100 questions, but of which we have to solve on any 60 questions from that. So about part A, in part A, it consists of 11-12 syllabus, that is PCMB, which we have studied, mostly I think we have studied it. But what we have to do for part A, how to study. So as we know, bio part is already done with us in our BPharm days, or we know the concepts of biology, about plant, animal, and all that. So just what we have to do is the basics of maths, formulas, physics, formulas, or any theories or laws. And for chemistry, the reactions, like rearrangement reactions, carbocation, carbon, and basic chemistry, which we learn. Then what about E1, E2 reactions, SN1, SN2 reactions. These we have to learn the basics of chemistry and nothing else. So the most focus should be on bio part so that you can cover the marks in the part B. And PCM, maths, physics, they just questions are on basis of the formulae, basic formulae questions. So if you know the formula of speed, distance, time, and basic aptitude questions, like these many people are in row, then he's from back seventh, so what is the count? So these type of questions are also there from general aptitude. So for part A, the correct answer gives you 1 mark, and half mark is deducted from your answers for a wrong answer, that is negative marking. And this is about part A. So now about part B. Part B is basically about a biotech syllabus mostly. So it consists of bioprocessing, microbiology, biochemistry, like biomolecules, these part. So what you have to study is the core biotechnology, as a micro and biochemistry is done with us if you are studying for GPAT or any other exams, or in BPharm syllabus also. So the more focus should be on biotech parts or biotech topics so that you can score more marks in that. So for part B, what is the marking system? Is that 3 marks for correct answer and 1 mark is deducted for a wrong answer. The points or topics that should be learned are cell cycle, biomolecules, viruses, gene and chromosome, immunology, bioinformatics part, but that is not a main or major subject to learn. Just superficially, if you do with bioinformatics, that is enough. Then cell culture, animal biotechnology, or animal plant tissue culture, bioprocessing. Bioprocessing takes most of the questions in part B. So I think you should focus more on bioprocess, tissue cultures, enzyme modification, and analytical techniques. So analytical techniques like UV, mass, NMR, chromatography. So these are asked. Usually they don't ask about the theory part of these, but application-based questions are asked that how these NMR and UV and other analytical techniques can be used in in any bioprocess or biotechnology or biochem your topics or part. So just learn or about applications in the analytical techniques and nothing more. So this was about part A and part B. So syllabus and marking system. So as I said, it consists, it is of 20 to 40 marks. So the part A consists of 60 marks, one mark each, 60 questions. And part B is 100 questions from which you have to solve 60 questions. So 60 into 3 equals to 180. So total 60 plus 180, 240 marks question paper it is. So this was about brief about what is syllabus and all. So next is students say that if we qualify the exam or what. So can do we get any stipend or is there no stipend for that? So if you take admissions, if you qualify GATB, and on that basis or on that marks, if you take admission in any GATB listed college, so for MTech courses, it is 12,000 stipend per month. And for other courses like MSc, Biotechnology and Agriculture, there is other stipends. I think it is 7,000 and 5,000 respectively. So this is about stipend part. So many of you have questions like how the non-GPAT qualified students are helpful in giving GATB. So they have a next chance or opportunity to be in a good institute like ICT or any other institute to pursue in biotechnology. So it is a great chance, and nothing you have to study more about other than GATB syllabus, as you have covered most of the part in the GPAT, and that would help you in the GATB. Only the biotechnology part and the physics, chemistry, physics, maths part you have to focus on, and nothing more. So the non-GPAT qualified has a great opportunity, and they can surely take part and fill the forms for the GATB. So this is it. Pratik, any other questions you have?
No other questions I have. Else want to else something else you want to add up in this from your side?
No, it is all about that.
Okay. Why did you choose? You can tell. Why not you choose in some good M-Pharm college? Why not the core M-Pharm subjects like pharmaceutics, pharmaceutical analysis, or any other core subjects from pharma background? Why did you choose this biotechnology specifically?
Okay, so I don't have any good rank for GPAT or NIPER. So I thought that why should I shouldn't I take admission in good reputed college than any other M-Pharm college in Maharashtra through GPAT.
Okay.
And I got the opportunity by GATB exam and I qualified. So I didn't think of any GPAT based college in Maharashtra. And my NIPER rank was not too good to be in the NIPER. So this was a great opportunity for me to be in a good college.
So would you suggest that GATB as a second option plan B with an GPAT?
Yeah. Of course, it is a great chance for the people who have not qualified the GPAT this year. They can have the same knowledge and same study, and they can qualify next exam like GPAT. So it is a plan B. It can be their plan B, or they can have a. They don't have any regret if they take admission in ICT than any other.
Thanks, Vibhusha, for giving us a brief idea about the CAT. And thanks for joining me.
Yeah, I would add something.
Yeah. You want to add something?
I would add something.
Yeah.
Yeah. That if people don't qualify the GPAT, GATB exam or anything, the forms for ICT and other branches of ICT, ICT's separate exam have been opened. The form filling deadlines are open. So they can apply for other courses also, like pharmaceutical chemistry and technology, perfumery, dye stuff, green tech, and many others. So for New Jalna campus has also these exams, and Mumbai campus also has the exam. So they have a great second opportunity other than GATB to come in ICT. So they can also fill forms for that.
Okay. Thanks for that information.
Yeah, I'm welcome.
Yeah. So with this, we are ending our discussion. So and even if having any query, they can just add up in their queries in the comment section. And I hope Ms. Vibhusha will answer your comments.
Yeah, sure.
So with your consent, may I just drop your mail ID also in the description to get some info?
Yeah.
They just can contact you.
If directly. They have any queries, they can about GATB or ICT, they can mail me.
Yeah.
I will drop my email ID.
Yeah, thank you. So with that, we are ending our discussion. Thank you, Ms. Vibhusha. Thanks. Thanks a lot.